I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by like Lady.
All right, welcome to episode 2.
I'm Anna.
I'm Bardi.
Bardi. Anna.
Okay, first topic we're going to discuss is definitely, you know, out there a lot in the media.
Yeah, everyone's aware of it. The Chris Brown and Rihanna incident.
Don't hit me. So, Chris Brown
hit Rihanna. There are different stories out there on this one.
Haven't you seen the pictures?
Yeah, but I mean, the beating is the same story, but either she was texting a boy or something about herpes.
Oh, no, she didn't.
Girl.
I was like, yeah,
please.
She did. Get over it.
Yeah, get over it.
I think Chris Brown's
stepdad did it to his mom.
So he thought it was okay.
You know, it's just like a psychological thing. Like, he grew up with it, and even though he's always talked about how bad violence is, domestic violence, you know, it's
yeah,
like...
It's his upbringing.
Right, and it sucks, you know? It's his fault, but yet...
It is his fault, but it's almost like it was bound to happen.
Shooby dooby 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 doo wah. Anna M. Bardi Show.
Woo!
It's really, really good, you know.
Yeah.
We have a lot of fun, and we are so cool, because we are Anna and Bardi. Woo! We rule.
Yeah. Our first movie is He's Just Not That Into You.
Okay, I really liked it.
I thought it was okay.
I mean, the one major thing that they were talking about in the beginning was how when you're young and, like, a boy is mean to you, everyone's like, oh, it's because he likes you.
That's not true.
And little girls believe it.
That is why girls are so messed up. I say when you have a kid and a boy hits her, you say that boy doesn't like you.
So, you ready to rate it?
Yep. I've got my number.
Okay. One, two, three.
Oh, very, very different. So overall, the movie gets a 7, since I gave it
right.
a 6, and you gave it an 8.
I really liked it, but...
It was too long. Cut a few scenes out.
Yeah. So we get a 7.
It was funny, it was funny.
Right.
Comical.
It was
good. Okay, also, we have both seen 2 different movies, so I'm going to rate Coraline. Tim Burton's new movie, it was... one of the weirdest movies I have ever seen. If I had to rate it, I'd probably give it... Also, I would not send your kid to see that movie. That was not a child's movie. I was scared. 19 years old. So I would say I'd give it also a 6. I mean, because it kept you entertained, but... Weird.
Okay, and the movie that I saw that Bardi didn't was Taken. And that's that movie where... this guy's daughter is, like, abducted in Europe, and he has to get her back. Amazing. I loved it, you know? I thought it was really, really good. I couldn't see it, like, a second time because it's, the best part about it is the suspense, and you don't know what's gonna happen. And so, since I already saw it, it's like, I know what's gonna happen, so, you know, it's gonna take away from that. But honestly, I would recommend it for sure. I'm going to give it a 8.5.
I'm planning on seeing that one.
Right.
Go do it up.
All right. The next...
Our next segment on the show is how to entertain yourself
when you are bored.
There's a range of things you can do. All very entertaining.
Say cool whip. Cool whip. Say cool. Whip. Now say cool whip. Cool whip.
Close your eyes and do this. It's like... a fireworks show.
Yeah.
Do it. Like, the lights.
Oh.
It's like all these lights flickering.
It also makes you dizzy, so.
Right.
And another great thing to do when you want to, like, you're bored, It's very easy. You just strobe light really fast.
It's like a rave.
It's like a little rave in your brain.
You can make origami out of dollar bills.
Oh, yeah, that's fun. You can make t-shirts and boxes.
And picture frames.
Picture frames. That's a cool one. Also, when you're bored, it's fun to... Well, I personally just like eavesdropping. That's fun.
That is always fun.
That's so
fun. Like, if you're at, like, a public place. I like putting my headphones in and, like, pretending like I'm listening to music, but I'm really not. And then I just totally am listening to the conversation next to me.
It's so funny. You make, like, farting sounds. People around you think you farted.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely not my idea of fun, but, I mean, that I could definitely see you enjoying that.
It's really great.
One of my favorite things, I did this when I was in show choir, and our choir director would, like, give us an inspirational speech. I know it's kind of inappropriate, but I would pretend like he was talking to a group of hookers. And then so he would be like saying like, you guys did great out there, you know, just make sure to give it your all next time. And I don't know, I loved that.
That is so, that is a great idea.
That is fun.
So I guess you could do that as like your teacher was talking.
Like, pretend, yeah, right.
Pretend you're...
I mean,
something.
It's a little trickier, like, if their teacher's talking about, like, political science.
Gotta,
doesn't work as much.
You gotta be clever.
So that's
yeah,
how to keep
good.
Yourself entertained.
Today, while working at my cash register, a man who was 6'3 came in, dressed really nice, and ordered. After he ordered, I asked why he was dressed so nice. He responded, "I'm going to court for stalking pretty girls like you. Our name tags have full names. F my life." That was our favorite one today. It was really fun. I just thought it was really funny. Kind of creepy, but
right.
Really funny.
I would tell that girl to get some mace.
How'd you like that, America? I liked it.
This is awkward. People keep walking by the windows.
Giving us odd looks when we're talking to a screen. We're actually talking to you!
You'd act like me beating you up.
I didn't.
Because we have fun, we are the one you wanna watch. Cool girls from school girls, we don't do much but play. We like to buy toys at Walmart because we really like Walmart. We never go to Target anymore.
There's no Targets around.
There's just a lot of Walmarts, those stores. I think it's because the Walmart founder Sam Walton went to Brazil.
Oh! Today is the 21st.
Today is the
22nd.
People suck. I don't know why I just came out and really arched too.
Oh, okay.
My phone is ringing. Like the whole time you're on the edge of your seat. And you don't. This is a businessman hiring a prostitute.
A really great prostitute.
Well,
okay, hiring a prostitute.